We were there this morning as a Story County teenager is sentenced to prison for a deadly accident. Good afternoon, everyone. Thanks for joining us today. A friend of Caleb Hoverston was killed. Two other people seriously injured in the accident. This morning, Angie Hunt was in the courtroom when the judge handed down the sentence. She's joining us now live from our exclusive Ames Live link with all the details. Angie, what happened?
Well, Molly, it was an emotional morning as the judge sentenced 18-year-old Caleb Hoverston to 15 years in prison. You may recall that Hoverston admitted his guilt back in September for his role in the crash that killed 16-year-old Bryce Nelson and injured 14-year-old Tori Page and 38-year-old Will Schrader. During today's sentencing, the mother of Bryce Nelson made a victim impact statement. Jean Halton placed a photo of her son on the witness stand. The picture, she told Hoverston, was taken just 38 hours before Bryce was killed in the deadly crash in May. Halton told Hoverston she would never be able to forgive him for what he did to her son, but Halton says she had always told her son Bryce that everyone deserves a second chance. And so she told Hoverston to use his second chance and his time in prison to get an education and then pay it forward. 15-year-old Tori Page had to use crutches to walk up to the witness stand to give her statement. She described the pain she has gone through since the accident and how she still has several surgeries ahead of her as part of her recovery.
I can't and I won't forget this accident. I can't because, first of all, one of my best friends is now dead. And second, because I have so many scars from this accident. So far, I have 13 and I still have more surgeries to go.
Caleb, I don't believe that you intentionally tried to kill Bryce and severely injure Tori and Mr. Schroeder. But you did, and I will never be able to forgive you for that.
And Hoverston did start to tear up as the two women gave their victim impact statements this morning. He did have a chance to address the court before he was sentenced, and Hoverston apologized to the victims and their families for the pain he caused. As you'll recall, this accident happened when Hoverston led police on a high-speed chase back in May after he stole $52 in gas.
There is nothing that I can do to change what happened. If there was, I would in the blink of an eye.
And we'll have much more from today's sentencing coming up later today on News Channel 8. We also talk after the sentencing with the family of Tori Page, who said the sentence that Hoverston received today was not long enough.
All right, Angie Hunt reporting for us. Thanks, Angie.